Hi everyone, it's lovely to see you here today. Thank you for joining me. I'm going to be reading you a story and I'm also going to be sharing some ideas for activities that you can do as well afterwards. So shall we begin then? So first of all, I'm going to sing you a little song. Are you ready? Hello everyone, it's nice to see you here. Listen very carefully. Let's see what we have here. What do we have here? We have Elmer the Elephant. And this is the story I'm going to be reading to you guys today. Shall we get ready? Get your listening ears on. There once was a herd of elephants. Elephants young, elephants old, elephants tall or fat or thin. Elephants like this, that or the other, all different but all happy and all the same colour. That is, except Elmer. Elmer was different. Elmer was patchwork. Elmer was yellow, orange, red and pink and purple, blue and green and black and white. Elmer was not elephant colour at all. It was Elmer who kept the elephants happy. Sometimes he joked with the other elephants and sometimes they joked with him. But if there was even a little smile, it was usually Elmer who started it. One night, Elmer couldn't sleep for thinking. And the thing that he was thinking about was that he was really, really tired of being different. Whoever heard of a patchwork elephant? He thought. No wonder they all laugh at me. In the morning, before the others were really awake, Elmer slipped quietly away unnoticed. As he walked through the jungle, Elmer met other animals. They always said, good morning, Elmer. Each time, Elmer smiled and said, good morning back. After a long walk, Elmer found what he was looking for. A large bush. A large bush covered with berries. A large bush covered with elephant-coloured berries. Elmer caught hold of the bush and shook it so hard that the berries fell to the ground. Once the ground was covered in berries, Elmer laid down and he rolled over and over, this way and that way and back again. Then he picked up the bunch of berries and rubbed himself all over, covering himself with berry juice, until there wasn't any sign of yellow, orange, red or pink or purple or blue or green or black or white. When he had finished, Elmer looked like any other elephant. After that, Elmer set off back to the herd. On the way, he passed the other animals again. And this time, each one said to him, good morning, elephant. And each time Elmer smiled and said, good morning, and he was pleased that they wasn't recognising him. When Elmer rejoined the other elephants, they were all standing quietly. None of them noticed Elmer as he walked his way to the middle of the herd. After a while, Elmer felt something was wrong. But what? He looked around. Same old jungle, same old bright sky, same old rain cloud that was coming over from time to time. And lastly, same old elephants. Elmer looked at them. But the elephants were standing absolutely still. Elmer had never seen them so serious before. The more he looked at the serious, silent, still standing elephants, the more he wanted to laugh. Finally, he couldn't bear it any longer. He lifted his trunk. At the top of his voice, he shouted, "Boo!" The elephants jumped and fell always in surprise. "Oh my gosh and golly," they said. And then they saw Elmer, helpless with laughter. "Elmer," they said, "it must be Elmer." Then the other elephants laughed too, as they had never laughed before. As they laughed, the rain cloud burst, and when the rain fell on Elmer, his patchwork started to show again, and the other elephants were still laughing as Elmer was washed back to normal. "Oh, Elmer," gasped an old elephant, "you've played some good jokes, but this has been the biggest laugh of all. It didn't take you long to show your true colours." "We must celebrate this day every year," said another. "This will be Elmer Day. All the elephants must decorate themselves, and Elmer will decorate himself elephant colour." Wow, look at that. That is exactly what they did. One day of the year, they decorate themselves and parade. On that day, if you happen to see an elephant, an ordinary elephant in ordinary elephant colour, you will know that that one must be Elmer. Can you see Elmer here? So all these ones are decorating themselves in all different colours, aren't they? That's the end of the story. It was a lovely story, wasn't it? And I've got some activities that you could try at home now to make yourself a very colourful Elmer. Shall I show you what to do? So here, I've done my very own Elmer the Elephant. And what I've done is I've got an old milk carton, and this is a job for grown-ups. I've cut the carton of milk in half. So I've got the handle here for the trunk. Can you see? I've cut the top off where the lid goes and covered it up. And then children, boys and girls, can cover the elephant in different tissue paper or different card if you haven't got any tissue paper, in small squares, just using a prick stick, and stick it on. And at the front, I've put some googly eyes there. Can you see? Yeah. Do you want to have a go at making one of these at home? If you have a try, send me some photos. I'd love to see yours. If you've got some different colours there as well. Next, I thought it'd be a really good idea to try and do a colour search in your home. So if your grown-ups can make you some cut-out circles of different colour, you can use card, you can use different paper, you can use old cereal packs that you can colour and paint on the other side. So I've done blue, I've done orange, or if you have any bowls that are nice different colours, you could use as well. And what you have to do is, using the colours, if you've got orange and pink, you have to go around your home and find different objects of that colour. So in my house, I've got an orange straw. I've got an orange crayon as well. So let's have a look and see what you can collect at home. Now, if you want to extend that activity, parents, it's a really nice idea to choose one colour. So, for example, if you wanted to choose yellow and you're taking your children out for a walk, or you're just playing in the garden, or you're going to a park somewhere or a nice garden, do a little bit of exploring and see what things that you can find out there of that colour. So, for example, so you might be able to find some nice pretty yellow flowers. It might be some signposts or markings in the road. So concentrate on one colour and let the little ones have a look around and see what they can find. And it's all about exploring, isn't it? And sort of really, really looking hard to see what's in their environment and paying attention. So next, because Elmer is all about colour and all about, you know, different colours and being different and having lots of fun, he's very fun, isn't he, Elmer? I thought it'd be a nice idea to do some water play. but using different coloured water. So I've got an example here of some blue water, and all I've done is just added a little bit of food colouring into that. And you can pour this water into any like Tupperware tubs are a really good idea, any jugs, plastic jugs that you've got, plastic beakers. You could use empty, clean yogurt pots, or a washing up bowl even, and just have lots of different colours for the children to explore and pour and tip. It's a really nice thing to do, and it's something different, isn't it, than using just plain water. Next, this is another really nice painting idea. You will need, as I've done here, an Elmer the Elephant. You see here? I've just copied Elmer from the cover of the book, but if you wanted to, you could download a template and print it out from the internet. It's really easy to do your own, and it doesn't have to be perfect. And what we're going to do here is have lots of different colour paints on offer. So you could put the little dab of paint around a plastic plate or a paper plate if you've got any at home. And we're going to do some finger painting. And you're going to end up with an Elmer the Elephant like this, all different colours. So it's your own patchwork Elmer. Yeah? Looks good, doesn't it? Now, on the storybook, Elmer is patchwork. It's all squares, isn't it? So another really good idea if you wanted to do squares on Elmer is have some small cubes of cheese, and if you have some lollipop sticks, you could push the lollipop sticks into the top or use a fork and dip your cubes into the coloured paint and make prints like this. This is a really lovely activity and a really good idea. If you guys choose to do some of these activities at home, I'd be really, really happy if you could send some photos. You could add them to the comments in this post. I'd really like to see all the fun that you're having at home. I hope I've given you some really good ideas there, and I hope you're going to have lots and lots of fun exploring all the different colours.